So recently it's just been working around the edit in Unreal Engine. So that's bringing in all of our video files, our motion capture of both face and body, and just assembling this timeline as you would with a traditional piece of editing software, but inside Unreal Engine.
So Unreal's cinematic workflow allows you to use things called timeline to nest game objects, animations, sound, media, all sorts of things onto a sequence that will play and keep things constrained and lined up. I'm currently setting up the shots for the planet side section of the film. So it's just bringing the motion capture data in and then putting it on the timeline. So this is using the motion capture data that we got from the motion capture shoot. We've retargeted it to our model, we've brought it into Unreal Engine, and now we can move our guy around the world. In terms of the content itself, it's nice to put all the stuff that's been in the back of my mind into practice, taking that theory and turning it into practical knowledge that make it this really standout project for me and unlike anything that I've ever done before.
Virtual production offers a unique blend of traditional filmmaking and animation. It leaves itself open for those moments of being able to be there with people, a crew, and to say, you know what, no, we're gonna do this differently, we're gonna experiment, we're gonna try something new. So yeah, it's just that flexibility that brings virtual production to be this really useful tool. Does it replace traditional filmmaking? No, absolutely not, but I think that there are places for them both to exist where they can be appreciated for their values and negatives.
I've enjoyed doing the sound effects, to be fair. Like, just watching through a video with no sounds and then just like dragging and dropping, even if it's just like footsteps. You just drag the footsteps in and position them in the right place, and then it starts to feel like the full thing. Then once you've got all the sound effects in, you've got like 20 tracks. You press play and it's like, oh, it actually sounds pretty good.
Making an atmosphere track for Voyagers. It's just trying to get the mood of space. A sense of dread. The longer the note, the more dread. For the full piece, it is just like the whole audio track from start to finish. And then any sound effects as well we need. It's a lot of just trial and error and just seeing what fits the vibe. It's gone pretty well from not knowing what I'm doing to now having a slight understanding of what to do.
I think it would be interesting to see what people think about the finished product. I want them to not know how many people were involved in making it. So they can be like, oh, this might be a big team or it might be a small team. But then you realize the creative side of it has been like 4 people. But I think that's quite impressive that you can get all of this stuff done.
I think it is positive to assume that everything will go wrong and then the only way is up.
So things have gone wrong. I'm currently like changing the eyes on some shots because things are just happening that shouldn't be happening. The entire team got COVID. In the space of a week, we went from like a full team working at full speed to, I think by the Friday, I was the only one in the office. And then I tested positive and then I was off for a week. So yeah, that was quite disruptive.
I wanted a real kind of like 60s, 70s video, early TV kind of vibe to it. So the character was rendered from a separate scene in Unreal, and then I'm just applying effects over the top. So I've got my effects layer and I'm turning it into something else using effects. And then this will go back into Unreal, and then we will be editing the film itself in Unreal, but these clips will kind of dynamically always play in the right spot as we move things around because it's in Unreal.
I've actually really enjoyed just making films again and kind of getting the filmmaking language back into my work and going, oh yeah, all this compositing stuff and the composition of a shot and kind of where a camera should be in this world is, yeah, it's fun. I enjoy that. Yeah. And I just want people to start having a go, like just make a film. Like, we are using higher end kit, but there are certain parts of this that you just need a phone and a computer and that's it. It's amazing what you can do with just a phone now. I hope you enjoy watching the film we made called Voyagers.